Hello, I'm David Guthrie with His Word Lives Ministry, and I want to welcome you once again to this Christian message. We're going to be in the book of James today, and I'd like to read the first 12 verses and starting out the book of James. James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greeting. My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that ye may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. If any of you lack wisdom, let him ask of God, that giveth to all men liberally, and unbraideth not, and it shall be given him. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea driven with the wind and tossed. For let not that man think that he shall receive anything of the Lord. A double-minded man is unstable in all his ways. Let the brother of low degree rejoice in that he is exalted, but the rich in that he is made low. Because of the flower of the grass, he shall pass away. For the sun is no sooner risen with a burning heat, but it withereth the grass, and the flower thereof falleth, and the grace of the fashion of it perish. So also shall the rich man fade away in his ways. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation. For when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. Isn't it an exciting thing to know that God has promised us a crown of life for those that love him? Isn't it a beautiful thing to know that because of our trust and faith and relationship in God, that we have an ability to be tempted and tried and still remain patient in things in life because we have God taking care of us, leading us, guiding us, showing us how to take care of things along the way in this life. Praise God for what our salvation does for us. Praise God for the life, the abundant life, the spiritual, divine intervention of godly life that we can have as Christians. Praise God for salvation. Praise God for abundant life. Praise God for the new creation in Christ. Yes, the creation, the Christian life. Praise God for that life and how it is in the relationship that we can have through our faith and trust in Jesus Christ. If you don't know Jesus in your life, you've still got to answer a question. What are you going to do with Jesus? Are you going to believe in him as the Son of God or not? This is the day of your salvation. Get down on your knees, believe in Jesus and be saved and experience a new life and enjoy a peace inside of you that your destiny is taken care of and you have a permanent relationship and a permanent peace in what's going to happen to you even on into eternity. You can do that today by professing Jesus as the Son of God and believe that he died on a cross, a death. He shed his blood to pay the penalty for your sins. If you believe and have faith in that, and you trust in Jesus in your life, you commit and trust in Jesus and believe in God and what he did with his Son. He loved you so much that he gave up his only begotten Son. He sent him to the cross to pay the penalty for your sins, so your sins could be taken care of and washed away. And then, through your belief and faith, you can have an everlasting relationship with God. Praise God for the blessings today. I'd like to read some scripture today. I'd like to go ahead and go on into prayer time today. I want to pray for Lee Garrett, and a dear friend of mine, and I want to pray for her and care about her and the passing of her dad. I'd like to pray with Debbie Davenport as she has prayer for Elena that's in remission from leukemia. We'd like to pray with Daniel Worthy and just pray for him and his new position at Newtown Baptist Church. We want to pray with Diane Moore that's out there working a truck driving job. And we want to pray that God would be with her and lead her and protect her. We want to pray for Melissa Bell that has a hospital situation in her health. And Misty Clements, we want to pray with her about her health. We want to pray with Joyce Holbert as she asks prayer for Gary for his back and wound healing. And we want to pray for Paul's sister Lynn and her family that's recovering from a burn accident. And we want to pray for CJ's friend Gypsy that her mom has passed away and Nathaniel and the kids. And we want to pray for Denise and her health. And we want to pray for Jane as she seeks a new job and also the immigration process. And we want to praise God for Rite Oak Baptist Church and the growth that we're experiencing in our congregation. And also for our fundraisers for our sanctuary and fellowship hall building. And let's go to the Lord and pray now and lift up your prayer requests. Praise God today. Another beautiful day of life with Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Dear God, we come to you today and we thank you for all the many blessings that you make possible for us. Oh, we thank you for the life that you give us, the gift of eternal life. God, we pray for those that are seeking you out and that they might be saved today through their belief and faith in you. We pray for all those that don't know you. We pray for these that we've made mention of here today, their health situations and the other things that we've made mention of, new jobs and other things that we've made mention of. And we lift all of these things up along with the prayers of those that are viewing this ministry. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you for being with us today. God bless you. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.